acknowledge the presence of Nick Hansen from Fruit Growers Tasmania and Wayne Johnson from the Tasmanian Farmers and Graziers Association, and also Dr. Lloyd Klump, the General Manager of Biosecurity Tasmania. Clearly, we are facing a very serious issue in Tasmania with respect to the detection and incursion of fruit fly. We have Biosecurity Tasmania out there in the field now working across four sites. Three of those sites are on Flinders Island, and one site, northern Tasmania, northwestern Tasmania, at Sprayton near Devonport. Our biosecurity relative pest and disease free status for Tasmania is crucial. Crucial for accessing key markets and supporting our rural and regional and Tasmanian economy. Biosecurity Tasmania staff are working extremely hard to contain and eradicate fruit fly and the fruit fly larvae. Work is being done on all of those four sites across Tasmania, again three on Flinders Island and one on mainland Tasmania. There are two key priorities for us as a government and indeed all of Tasmania. And that is firstly to contain and eradicate. That is the primary focus of all those Biosecurity Tasmania staff, and indeed you've just seen the Incident Control Centre here at Mount Pleasant, and what is happening here is a whole of government response to the fruit fly detections over the course of the last week. The second key area is we're working very hard to maintain our market access, and what we are clearly demonstrating through trap data and the like is area and regional area freedom of fruit fly. That allows us to support existing areas around Tasmania that have not had a detection of fruit fly, such as the Derwent Valley and the Huon Valley in southern Tasmania. That remains also in parallel to containment and eradication a very key priority. Clearly, our fruit growing industry in Tasmania is paramount importance. It's a $100 million industry, but particularly our cherry industry in Tasmania is the most vulnerable at this stage. Can I also say that of those four areas that Biosecurity Tasmania are working on, these are residents, backyards, in this case apricot trees, as I understand it, have contained the fruit fly larvae. So there is no evidence or detections of fruit fly larvae in any commercial operations, as I understand it. We're increasing our trapping zones and trapping area and the number of traps, particularly in the key four areas, in this case the Western Incident in Sprayton, mainland Tasmania, is of paramount importance. Biosecurity is critical for maintaining market access and protecting Tasmania's clean, natural and safe brand. My understanding, the third became apparent within the last 24 hours, but I'll confirm that with Dr. Klump, but that is my understanding, yes.
And what exactly is being done in the Sprayton area to contain it to that suburban backyard?
Well, all the fruit along a 200 and 250 metre radius is being stripped, all the trees are being stripped. All the fruit that has fallen from the trees is being bagged and contained, in my understanding then frozen in this case. And so we are reducing the risk as much as possible. Of course, no fruit is coming, going outside that control zone, if you like. And also we're increasing the number of traps within that control zone as well. And the good news is there's been no flies trapped within the fruit fly traps around Tasmania, and we have more than 1,000 traps right across Tasmania, and not one fly has been detected in those traps.
Tasmania, if it is fruit fly larvae.
Well, this is where it's important that we work very closely with our Commonwealth counterparts. So within the domestic trade, there is also protocols in place there. So for the export of fruit within a 15 kilometre zone around, say, the Spreyton area, there will be a permit system applied for any export of fruit to interstate. But when it comes to more sensitive markets, such as those international markets and our Asian markets, we're working very closely with the Commonwealth on keeping those lines of communication open and working very hard at ensuring that we get regional status.
Tasmania, if it is fruit fly larvae.
Well, this is where it's important that we work very closely with our Commonwealth counterparts. So within the domestic trade, there is also protocols in place there. So for the export of fruit within a 15 kilometre zone around, say, the Spreyton area, there will be a permit system applied for any export of fruit to interstate. But when it comes to more sensitive markets, such as those international markets and our Asian markets, we're working very closely with the Commonwealth on keeping those lines of communication open and working very hard at ensuring that we get regional status.
Of the restrictions of fruit veg coming into the country, coming into the state, given that you have contained 50 tonnes of material, clearly something's not working there.
Well, we are always working on increasing our communication with the public, and you may well have noticed with the doubling of detector dog teams at our key ports of entry around Tasmania, that is working clearly in terms of sending the message to public. We also have multilingual signage as well at our key airports, main ports of entry, to ensure that our visitors, and we want as many visitors coming to Tasmania as we can. We welcome tourists from wherever they come from, but we also have to be very mindful that the increasing number of tourists, of course, increases the risk as well. The increasing amount of trade, it increases our risk as well. And so we have to be very vigilant in that communication. And this is where I really appreciate the public's involvement. In fact, I rang the person that in Spreyton that reported the suspect larvae to the appropriate authorities, and thanked that individual profusely.
So how concerning is this?
Oh, it's very concerning. It's a huge concern to detect larvae on mainland Tasmania and on Flinders Island.
I mean, it happened before in 2011. Are you hoping that it's just contained to this area?
2011 was the detection of two male flies in the Glenorchy area in a trap. The area that we're talking about now is a larval detection. Is distinctly different from that. On Flinders, I've personally been to Flinders Island myself in the last, for a day and a half, in the last 2 days. I've been working closely with the biosecurity people on Flinders Island, and certainly it's an opportunity to say that we're fully supportive, the Tasmanian fruit growing industry is, and berry industry is fully supportive of the efforts by biosecurity and certainly of the government. They're throwing every resource at it, been extremely transparent with the information that's been given to us, and we'll continue along that path hopefully for the next period of time.
The industry was pretty adamant that it wouldn't spread to mainland Tasmania. Is this quite surprising that it has?
I mean, to use the word spread is probably a little bit too strong a word at the point. We've got larval detection. We have no fruit fly detection in the traps at present. I mean, we could possibly be talking about a non-viable density, which is more than possible in these situations. So at the end of the day, it's very, very early days. So let's revisit that question in a couple of weeks' time.
What could the potential be for domestic and international markets for
Tasmania? Oh, it can have severe ramifications, obviously, but at this point, it's way too early to talk about that. And as I said, let's just deal with the larvae at this point in time.
How much the industry relies on
varies depending on the industry. Cherries, for example, probably can export probably 75% to 65 to 75% of our crop load. Apples is a little bit different to that. The domestic consumption of apples is quite high, export is quite low. In blueberries and raspberries, certainly, and strawberries, obviously very, very low export, but certainly very high domestic movement into mainland Australia.
So what are your
Well, as to date, we've had little to no feedback from our customers. They're quite relaxed, and as the Minister said, the area of freedom, the PFA areas down south in Huon Valley and Derwent Valley areas, are pest-free areas, and that's where the majority of the commercial fruit-growing areas of Tasmania are located, and certainly that's the areas that are still in